That was some mighty fine social disruption there, Caitlin, I have to say.
Ah, was it just the nudge that Abby needed?
You're an evil genius.
Who do you think is going to make the first move? Nick or Abby?
Ooh, good cue. My bet's on either.
I don't know. Nick's got the beast in him.
If by beast, you mean some sort of mild-mannered baby deer.
Hey, don't let that cute, preppy aesthetic fool you. It's like a steel barbecue grill under that shirt.
So, you noticed that too, huh?
So, what do you guys want to do now?
We can keep playing.
Yeah? Just the three of us?
All right, Dylan. Truth or... That sounded like Abby.
Oh my gosh.
We gotta help her.
Wait, where did it come from?
This way. Come on.
Abby! Help! Please! Nick! Help him!
Where's Nick?
Go after Nick! Go!
Maybe you should go.
Look, I gotta help Abby. Go! He might be hurt too! That shotgun's got a hell of a spread. Be careful!
Not.
Hey, can you walk?
Jack, gotta go.
Come on. Get back to the fire.
Stupid.
Jesus. There's a half-naked girl waiting for you back there, Jacob. What are you doing? Man, just let me down, okay? Just don't hurt me, please. Oh, Jesus Christ, what the fuck are you doing? Son of a bitch.
Helps if you close your eyes.
Oh, oh. What are you doing? Shh. Stop. Help. Shh. Help.
Tastes bad, don't it? It's for your own good. Where are you off to now, girlie?
What the fuck? What the fuck?
Seems like just a blink, and you're back to see me again.
So, then, what have we got? It's the star. Stars. Stars in the night. Sky. Beacons of light. Dreams of hope, purpose, or a reminder of our insignificance. Fear of despair, trust in the light of the star, with it comes clarity, and sometimes truth. The tower. Jump free of your troubles. Fight or flight? That's the question we all ask ourselves, but often, when leaping out of danger, we're still faced with certain peril. Watch your step. It could be your last. Remember, there's always more than meets the eye. Would you like me to show you? Yes, good, but I can only delve deeper into one possible future. So which is it? Choose.
to it then. Back to Hackett's Quarry. Back to Hackett's Quarry you go. Oh, the fun you'll have.
That was horrible. I don't even know what it was. It was so fast, and there was a hunter, and it was just...
Oh, Abby. Here.
What?
Oh, try drawing.
Drawing what?
Well, can you draw what attacked you?
Okay. So. Nick. Hey, buddy. Can you tell me what those guys did to you?
Gosh, did.
He's super out of it.
Yeah. The hunter.
Yeah. There was a guy. There was something else. Some kind of animal.
What kind of animal?
No, I only saw a dude trying to take him away. He's probably just disoriented, that's all. The dude was massive and angry.
Is Abby?
Yeah, she's okay, dude. She's right over there.
Be close. Teeth were on top of me. I think it was a bear.
Full-size bear would have crushed him. There's no way.
I thought we don't get bears right here.
Oh, fuck.
Look at that. Oh, shit.
That black stuff? That's infection. It's spreading. This is bad. This is really bad, dude.
Sorry. You're okay. It's okay.
Fuck that.
We should amputate. We should cut it off before the infection spreads.
What?
Why would we do that?
I don't know, man. Look at that black stuff.
What do you think it is?
Do I look like a doctor?
I can't remember much. I mean, I don't even know what I saw.
Holy shit.
Fuck. And I know how to use it! Sort of.
Ryan, what if it's Jacob or Emma?
What if it's not?
Be careful. It was probably nothing.
Yeah. But is it gone? Yeah, you better run.
Very brave.
All right. So, Lodge is sounding pretty good right about now, yeah? Okay.
You were saying...
Shall we look?
Are you stupid? Let's get out of here. Oh, but what about Jacob and Emma? What if they come back and can't find us?
Let's leave a note. They'll catch up with us if they want to. Right now, we gotta make sure Nick and Abby are okay.
Nick's legs, all sorts of fucked up. I don't know how we're gonna get him all the way back.
I got it.
All right, let's go. What tonight brings. Okay, here's a riddle for you. What's got two thumbs and is suddenly riding solo on a freaky island in the dark? This fool. Well, one thumb. One available thumb. Okay. And it was here, on a strange, uninhabited island, that this brave young soul found herself. Okay, full disclosure, I've suddenly found myself on a strange, tiny little island all alone with nothing to do but show you guys around. So, there's a treehouse over there. I'm gonna go and see if I can't dish out some of that sweet, sweet panoramic goodness. Because here's the thing. Not that I wanna go back, because I don't, but even if I did, I can't, because then I'd look like the super needy one when he was the one who stormed off in the first place. You know what? Sorry, I'm venting. Oh, explorer venting. You know what? Fuck it. Let's do it. To the treehouse, fellow explorers! No prizes for guessing what these are. Can't say that I've used them. A little too au naturel for me, TBH. You know, I've never thought about where the waste goes. Oh, please God, no. Okay, we're gonna just go ahead and ignore that. So this island is like an unexcavated part of the quarry that rewilded itself after it flooded into the lake. Pretty cool, huh? You know, when I was little, I used to think that islands just kind of would float in the middle of the water, kind of like an airbed. But I'm older and wiser now and realize that not everything's always as it seems. Kind of like how you thought you were just having a hot summer fling and then it turns into babysitting a big hairy man-child. He's all sad because you don't want to go steady with him and write him love letters every freaking day. And while we're talking about it, you don't mind that we're talking about it, right? Why is it up to me to justify my feelings when he's the one who got all blah about it, you know? Oh, look. A metaphor in the narrative by means of a fork in the road. How fitting. Here's the big question. Do I take the high road, literally, and forget about it? Or do I continue on the path I'm on and keep ranting about my stupid dumb life? I guess since this isn't live, the choice is up to me. Ah, what the hell? We're in it now anyway. Well and truly in the thick of it. Because you know what else? I was really excited for the next part of my life, you know? I mean, the summer was great, but what's next? I mean, come on. I know by the time I post this, Hackett's Quarry will just be but a distant memory, and I know it's just one night, and you have to make the most of all your opportunities, and yada, yada, yada. I guess I just don't want to have to settle for what's around me, you know? Abby sees me as this confident person, but really? I'm just desperate to stay afloat in a world where everyone wants to be different.
I feel like this is the first time I've been alone all summer. Kind of like it. I guess that kind of reinforces the whole Jacob thing. I know the plan was for him to come get me, but now that I'm by myself, I kind of like it. Sorry, Jacob, if you're watching. Nothing personal. It's a me thing. We're cool, right? Yeah, we're cool. I mean, who knows? Maybe in 50 years, we'll bump into each other and be flooded with fond memories of that one amazing summer at Hackett's Quarry summer camp, and that spark that changed our lives forever. Then we'll be like 70-year-old lovers or whatever and have crazy walker sex. Hey, it could happen. Only time will tell, Jakey boy, and as they say, time makes fools of us all. But we will be the oldest, sexiest fools there ever were. Until then, I gotta do my thing. Sorry, buddy. And this is the meeting shelter. It's a shelter where you meet at. Okay, I'm trying really hard to make this interesting, but sometimes a thing just is what it is. I think I've made my point. About it. How could this have been Mr. H when he was back at the lodge? Quoth the raven, nevermore. I guess I gotta do this one-handed, huh? That didn't sound great. Oh, shit. Just thought you should know. I am nailing this ladder climbing. All right. This is the luxurious Skyway Treehouse, obviously. Constructed in the year 1805 by a blindfolded man who used only the finest rotting wood, rusty nails, and donkey spit that money could buy. A real Hackett vintage classic. Honey, I'm home. What's that now? I forgot the children's bedtime. Well now, that's a fine how do you do. Take it all in, folks. That's the summer camp experience right there, and oh look, it seems somebody forgot to clear the place out. I guess one of the kids left their stuff, or maybe one of the guys back there? But I don't recognize this. Did you hear that? Looks like we have a choice on our hands. Do we snoop through someone else's belongings, or do we open the spooky trapdoor and die a horrible, painful death? There are literally no right answers. Goodbye, cruel world. The final curtain is calling, and there's no time for an encore.